Watching from. So we welcome you to CIS basketball tonight. Gigi's at 1-5, taking on the 5-1 in Western Conference League.
Lakehead team. Like you mentioned, Lakehead at the top of the OUA West Division, and they waste no time with a bucket right there at the top of the
rather 19 and 10 on the road last week, and Louis Gauthier, Greg Carter trying to drive that in the lane, and allows the fewest points per game for opponents. They have allowed the fewest total points far and away.
Grim, Greg, and so far Ottawa, you kind of timid on the inside here.
They are. They're allowing those cuts to the basket. Well, underneath as Lakehead crashes the boards. Definitely a problem for Ottawa is trying to get those second chance points last year in that playoff.
Points a game, well below what he was averaging last year in points, Greg, and maybe that's with the addition of some other new rookies and scores and other. Averaging around 20 points a game. Is that right, Greg? So
yeah. Well, I was going to say 20 he got against the Western last week. He's only scored 2 points in the first 4 minutes of this game. So, yes, as we were saying, Warren's got to be big in this game. He had going to try and catch him sleeping here on defense. Warren Ward on the wing. He's looking for the screen. Louis Gauthier backs into the lane. He's calling for it. The down low. If I'm Coach Darrenway, I like what I'm seeing here, giving Ryan the start, the sophomore guard out of Toronto.
We're seeing is we got to see Ottawa U toughen up their D on the inside. We're seeing Lakehead is going to getting to the line here today.
No signals here. That's going to be on Ryan Thompson as first. And Dave, it's time for Thunderwolves, and now he's showing his range from the outside. Warren Ward, he's got range as well, but there might have been too many steps or a foul away from the ball. Free throw line extended, nothing doing. Lakehead looking to build here on their couple of possession lead. A nice head. my memory did not serve me correctly, Lakehead holding their opponents to 34.3% shooting overall.
Over, and Lakehead runs on the fast break. As we saw, they got a couple of freebie dunks here. Lakehead who's completely certain who's going to play the point for them. And I think that it actually starts at the point.
And I like the Deron Williams comparison when you talk about Demetrius Seymour. You know, that would make one think that the and back, Johnny Verhaane in transition. And that's a tough shot when you got to slow down and square up for that 15-footer. Perfect transition into me saying we'll be right back. You're watching CIS basketball tonight with a minute left in the spending your Friday night with us here at the hall. Gigi's coach, James Darwin, said very tough loss. I've been waiting for them to have a big game like that as older guys and veterans on our team to step up and play like that. That from Coach James Darroway on the screen, or he's going to take the shot. He does take the shot. It's a tough one, leaning back, and Lakehead will hold on. Right there.
Well, it looked like they wanted to run an isolation play for Warren Ward there, Greg, and it just
Greg, Dave, and of course Jill Sally running the camera, producing everything you're seeing here, these awesome shots and
3-point line for Lakehead in the first quarter. They did. We just saw Jamie Searle hit that shot, making them 2-for-7.
Anto Reich from Brock shooting 53%. Andrew Krause also from Brock, 52%. Ryan Barbeau, the they're sixth in the nation, but I do like what they're doing here. It's a good observation, going kind of four guards and at such a quiet and good road team that they're making it happen. Jacob Gibson Bascom into the game, and that's going to be a blocking foul on Jamie's.
End of the floor there a few moments ago. So I think the G's need to tighten up the perimeter D. And we see
we'll see who it is on. Still missed that call.
to get some energy off the bench. And as we see, another easy look on the inside for Wenzel Russell, number six.
Off the pick. He shoots that from the corner. Gigi's 0-3 their last three possessions. Lakehead their last three possessions.
It's going to open up the inside. When they're playing well inside, they're going to collapse inside, leaving their three-point shooters open. So that's what's happening. The first three of his career, do you think? That's a good question, Greg. Well, Ottawa, you ran a play.
Scal, and I believe, no, those are the only two that came in. No, Ryan Malcolm Campbell makes an appearance, and best three-point shooter in the OUA last year, could not hit it. They throw it away, and Hackner gets stopped in the form. Play. Gigi's will get the foul. We're just talking about Louis Gauthier's three there. You know, Gigi's try anything, throwing a real.
He's at 6'9". He's really the only post player on the floor for the G's. And if you look, he's posting up pretty.
A little bit more streamlined, a little bit more quick. They're trying to, you know, run other teams off the court. You know, but as long as they tighten up their shooting. Matt Marshall making it go.
get their the offensive or the defensive rebound to push the ball back, but now you're leaving all their shooters wide open. So big man, and he's shooting it well, but geez, you got to go inside. 37-32, we've got 20.
A seesaw of a battle as we head into the halftime break, 39-32. Tune back into your computer. Ottawa edging 5 for 10, 50% from the three-point line, 40% for the Lakehead Thunderwolves, but Dave, a
outside, and he only played 2 minutes in the second quarter, so we're not sure what's going on with Warren Ward here, if it's either inconsistent.
Good spread on the floor here for Jamie Searle. Just enough of a hole. And Greg Carter with one on the clock, crashing the offensive board.
GG's has gone deep in their bench, and Coach James Darwin looking for some energy from the GG's bench. But you can tell Lakehead's
it quietly. Greg Carter with a nice move. Turns around. Back out to the perimeter. Joseph Jones wants to cross it over. Jacob pretty good look from there, but he does not even graze rim. Brendan King. Brendan King, who was 5 for 5 in the first half, misses a wide open.
Greg having a quiet night tonight, and he's not much of a shooter. They use him a lot more for his D and his speed. Loss, and Ottawa, you having the opposite record at five losses and one victory. And with 1:51 left in this quarter. They need to calm it down, run their offense, go through their regular scoring channels.
Back in the block, turns around, one on the clock. Side of the rim, no good. They got numbers in transition, the Thunderwolves. Going around a double defensive attack right there, and either Ryan Malcolm Campbell or Louis Gauthier will get whistled for the challenge.